Hello. I'm here to talk about a film I saw in the last week, Darkest Hour. I didn't get to it last week because I talked about The Last Jedi, but I would just say I really enjoyed the film. I thought it was really well made, well acted, particularly by Gary Oldman, who I believe I've spoken highly about on this channel before, but if I haven't, in essence, I'll tell you, or at least I'll tell you that I believe he's the best actor ever. He disappears in his roles so well. It's like he's like an actor like no other. Took me a long time to figure out that the guy who was Sid Vicious, Beethoven, Lee Harvey Oswald, Mason Verger from Hannibal, Sirius Black, and Commissioner Gordon were all the same person. It took me quite a bit of time before I realized they were all the same person, same guy played them all. I already talked about this movie, Dunkirk, this summer. But the reason I have it back here is because it has something to do with around that time, called Operation Dynamo. And you see the film, it's about Winston Churchill against Britain. And, okay, Dunkirk's in France. But, the movie, but it has a lot of British soldiers in. The whole film is basically, it's about 1 month of him, Winston Churchill, as a prime minister. And everything that's going on, like so many people they want to have peace talks with Hitler and not go to war. Well, Winston Churchill knows about Hitler, hates him, rightfully so. And he does not want peace agreements, but there's a lot of things that happen that it's like maybe peace could be very close to happening. It's just so, even though what's going to happen, it's still very tense. You are kind of like, well, how is this gonna play out? Like, I know how it happened. I know how it goes because of history, but exactly how? That was the really big question, and it was just an amazing movie. I'm not really gonna give any spoilers here, but this is a good companion piece for Darkest Hour. Or Darkest Hour is a good companion piece to Dunkirk, whatever you want to way you look at it. But yeah, Gary Oldman gives the performance of a lifetime as Winston Churchill. I believe he deserves an Oscar. He deserves every award, I think personally, that he gets nominated for, because he's so believable. He looks like Churchill. He sounds like Churchill. The best as one could sound like him, as well as look like it. It was just so amazing. He's really unrecognizable. Gary Oldman is a chameleon. I'd say he's the modern day man of a thousand faces. If you don't know who the man of a thousand faces is, it's Lon Chaney. Because way back in the silent era, he would change his face and be unrecognizable. Well, Gary Oldman is essentially that. He's basically unrecognizable in a lot of the movies he's in, and Even the films that he looks like himself, it takes a while for me to, you know, see him, because I'm so used to him, you know, basically made up, that it's kind of a bit jarring, if you will. And also, he's a master of accents, too, so even if he sounds like himself and looks like himself, it's kind of like, wait a minute, I gotta kind of take a step back a moment and realize who I'm watching. Because he's really that good, and I know I'm talking about really him, but, you know, all the actors in this film are amazing. The acting is great, so is the direction, but really, Gary Oldman is the guy who's the main, he's the main dude, he's the main guy, he's fantastic. Kristen, woman who's his wife, Kristen Scott Thomas, yes, okay, yeah. She plays Clementine Churchill, his wife, and she's amazing as well. Lily James is great. Winston Churchill's assistant. Ben Mendelsohn is amazing as the king. And, you know, John Hurt was supposed to be Neville Chamberlain. I can't think at the moment who it was who actually played him. Ronald Pickup. I don't believe I've seen him in anything. Maybe I have. He was in a movie called The Mission. I believe that had De Niro in it. But yeah, I really haven't seen anything he was in except for this. But yeah, he was amazing. Everybody was amazing. And I recommend it. I'd say it's one of my favorite films of the year. It is definitely a contender for Best Picture. I believe this is the best film of the year myself. Dunkirk was amazing. It was intense. And Darkest Hour, this film I'm talking about now, is a great companion piece to that film. If you enjoyed Dunkirk, yep, I think you might enjoy this film, just due to the companion of it. You know, Dunkirk is involved, but you don't ever see any actual battles. In the trailer, they show smoke and stuff, people over there with planes flying over. That's essentially the extent of that. You know, bombs are dropped, and that's it. That's all about Dunkirk. That's all of seeing Dunkirk as you will ever get. But, yeah, it's like a political film. I've never been the biggest fan of political films, though I do have a handful of movies I enjoy. Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, for instance. And I like The Ides of March. In this movie, Darkest Hour, will be one of my favorite political movies. One of the few that I could watch over and over again. Because of how... just how immersive and amazing those films are. And I recommend this movie. Recommend Dunkirk, though I already did that this summer. And, yeah, I recommend this film. These two movies is included. Yeah, those are my two favorite movies of the year. Those will be my top two best films of the year. They deserve as many awards as they get. And, yeah. You know, I enjoyed this film. I thought it was great. And, that's all I really have to say. I know I didn't do any Christmas films this year. Perhaps next year I will. No Star Wars film at all next December, at least not now. Solo is supposed to come out in May. So I could have talk about a few Christmas films next year. But that is all. This is the last video of this series. I will put up for this year. And there's some ups and downs throughout this year. Though then again, everybody kind of does have that. But aside from those downs I had, I think this was a pretty good year overall. And, I didn't mind it. I mean, there are, again, moments that I wish didn't happen, but can't really change the past. Actually, you can't. No, I said you can't really. You'd be implying that you can go back in time, and you can't. At least not now. Not that I'm aware of. But, thought this year was pretty good. Again, I will see you next year. Might put up a few videos before the year is completely out, but as of this series, I'll be back next year. So until then, thank you for watching. See you later.